Welcome to another Volvo video, my 2003 XC90. And in this video, I'm back to the running problems. So I'm basically following on from part 40, where I didn't get to the problem of why it's not running right. So to that end, I've decided to book it in with the local Volvo specialist, and I'm about to take it there. So I'll see you at the specialist. So I'm on the way, and the error message has come up, and I've never been so glad to see it. So the problem is definitely still there. I did see smoke coming out of the exhaust. I could probably put a bit of a B-roll footage of the exhaust smoking. I'll just get the footage out of the dash cam. You'll see what I mean. Anyway, I'm part of the way there to the specialist. So I'll catch up with you when we get there. So I've just dropped it off here at Volvo Specialist Car Sales. So time to make my way home. So I'm going through Brighouse at the moment. Now, I could get a taxi, but that cost me about 20 quid. Or, I don't need a direct train, so cheapest option is to get a bus. And to this end, I'm at Brighouse bus station. So, find out what time bus is and then get me back to Halifax. So yeah, I'm in Halifax town centre. There's a town hall. And the bus ride only costs £2 from Brighouse, so I'm going to make my own way home. And I'll catch up with you when I'm back at headquarters. So I finally made it back to HQ. They're going to have a look at it tomorrow. And the next clip you'll see will be when they tell me their findings. So it's quite a few days later. I took it to a specialist and actually rung me back the next day and told me what the problem was. This is a... The turbo needs stripping down and cleaning, and also the intercoolers are leaking as well, so I've given a go ahead to get it done. It's going to cost me, but it's a vehicle I need and it takes number one priority, so I'll come back to you when it's ready to be picked up, which should be in hopefully in the next few days. So I'm here at Volvo Specialist Car Sales. I'm back in the XC90. Did ask me to give it a road test, make sure it won't create the problem won't coming back. It didn't come back when I was driving it, and no smoke out the exhaust. So, and we should be all good. So what I'll do is I'll be going home, and I'll come back to you when I get home. So the warning message came back twice. First time going up a steep hill, it went into limp mode, but then it went out. And then another time I was joining the motorway because I went to Costco in Leeds to get some diesel. And when I joined the M62 at junction 26 going eastbound, it come on then. But since then, the warning message hasn't come on. Now I'm going to take it back to a specialist because they've promised me a headrest, for the third row seat. So I'll be grabbing that part. I couldn't do it tonight because it were basically closing time. So I'll come back another time, and you'll see that in a future video. When I do the head restraint. But like I says, since that second time, it's not come back. I've driven it around a bit. I think it's relearning with the new turbo and the intercooler. So I think the ECM is relearning. So I'm hoping it don't come back. But I'll let specialists have another look at it. I'm not going to read any codes or clear them. So I'm going to end this video here. I'm 950 quid lighter for the work I've done, which is basically. Have the turbo rebuilt and the new intercooler fitted. So I hope you enjoyed this one. As ever, thanks for watching, and I'll see you.